A circular economy is an industrial system that replaces the end-of-life concept with restoration, shift towards the use of renewable energy, eliminates the use of toxic chemicals which impair reuse and return to biosphere, and aims for the elimination of waste through the superior design of materials, products, system, and business models. Such an economy is based on a few simple principles as shown in the butterfly diagram. First, at its core, a circular economy aims to design out waste. Waste does not exist, products are designed and optimized for a cycle of disassembly and reuse. These tight components and product cycles define the circular economy and sets it apart from disposal and even recycling, where large amount of embedded energy and labor are lost. Second, circularity introduces a strict differentiation between consumable and durable components of a product. Third, the energy required to fuel the cycle should be renewable by nature, again to decrease resource dependence and increase system resilience. In this chapter, we shall study about the biological and technological components of a circular economy. Have you ever been confused between gifting an expensive box of goodies or a set of cutlery? You must have calculated the pros and cons of both, like how the goodies can be over in no time, but the cutlery will benefit longer. This suggests a basic difference between a consumable and a durable product. Box of goodies is a consumable product and a set of cutlery durable. Consumables are goods used by individuals and businesses that must be replaced regularly because they wear out or are used up. Food items are an example of consumable goods. A durable product cannot be consumed at once but gets depreciated by wear and time. For example, capital equipment, furniture, electronics, vehicles, sporting equipment. This has been the most followed categorization of materials so far. However, a circular economy categorizes materials on the basis of their degradation. The one that degrades at the end of life without polluting the environment are considered biological components, and the ones that cannot re-enter the ecological cycle are categorized as technical components. In a circular economy, the biological materials can re-enter the natural world and biodegrade without risk of polluting over time. These materials degrade if disposed properly at the end of life cycle, and the nutrients will be returned to the environment through a natural process. They are represented green in color in the butterfly diagram on the left-hand side. Technical materials such as plastics or synthetic chemicals cannot re-enter the natural world and will need to continuously cycle through a system that captures and recaptures their material value. They are represented blue in color in the butterfly diagram on the right-hand side. If we focus on the flow of technical and biological materials, we notice a difference of loops, each having a different value in accordance with how close they are to the center. We shall read more about them in the coming topics. Biological components are the living factors in our environment. This includes everything that goes in the making of organisms, species, population, community, ecosystem, biome, biosphere as a whole. Biological components together forming the biosphere are self-regulating. Characteristically, biological components are circular. These are essentially nutrients that are least non-toxic and possibly even beneficial, and can be safely returned to the biosphere either directly or in a cascade of consecutive uses. This can be known through cycling of matter. Cycling of matter sustains the biochemical cycles, keeping the natural feature of biological components. The Earth's biochemical systems involve complex, dynamic processes that depend upon many factors. Cycling of matter is one of the main factors upon which the life on Earth depends. This includes water cycle, carbon cycle, nitrogen cycle, and phosphorus cycle. A linear economic model of mining, processing, and throwing lead to a number of reactions and biological components resulting in biosphere imbalances. A constant supply needed in a linear model undermines the ability of biological components to regenerate. The application of circularity in the economy keeps biological components like land, soil, water as valuable as possible. These biological components provide services such as cleaning products such as fertile farmland, pollination, and clean drinking water. In a linear economy, these services are ultimately depleted by constant withdrawal of products or overburdening by the dumping of toxins. If these products are used in a cycle and the services are not burdened by the toxic substances, the soil, air, water bodies remain resilient and productive. Discarded substances from human activity are at crossroads with the biological components. For instance, acid rain. The principal cause of acid rain is sulfur and nitrogen compounds from human sources such as thermal power plants, factories, motor vehicle emissions, etc. This follows adverse impacts on surface water, aquatic animals, soil, forest, vegetation like crop, and ocean acidification. Lack of circularity in human activities through various industries are a reason for turning biological components of the ecosystem in unusual reactions. Other human influences on biological components occur through industrial, agricultural, and coastal projects like coastal roads, island creation, drilling, shipping, mining, to name a few. Each biological component is unique in nature. Waste for one biological component is food for another and are truly recyclable in nature. Biological components are victimized at the intersection between the economic activity and natural balances. What we do to our biological components ultimately is done to us, as we are the ones who are dependent on them, not they on us. In the butterfly diagram, blue color represents the technical material such as plastic or synthetic chemicals that cannot re-enter the natural world and will need to continuously cycle through a system that captures and recaptures their material value. If we focus on the flow of technical material, we notice a number of loops, each having a different value in accordance with how close they are to the center. The first and innermost loop consists of maintaining products and materials to remain in the economy for the longest possible time without generating waste. Since the circular economy is all about being strategic on the use of finite natural resources, durability removes the need to create new products. For this, it is essential that product manufacturers design for maintenance and repair. The second loop shows a strategy privileging product reuse and redistribution to new users in their original form with little enhancement. Digital marketplaces such as eBay are examples where reuse and sharing are effective and well-established approaches. Though innovative business models are required so as to remain competitive against the linear alternatives, new applied technologies such as artificial intelligence can help. The third loop, consisting of repairing objects that have been damaged and refurbishing those parts that need replacement in order to restore lost value instead of discarding them. And finally comes recycling or reduction of a product to its most basic material level in order to be converted into same or some other product. Though most people unfamiliar with these circular principles associated with recycling, in fact, it is the only least prioritized subcategory of the circular economy. A class of students were asked to imagine a pristine environment.
the class altogether fancied the same surroundings, one with no discarded materials. The teacher expressed how the students' reactions were usual and expected. The menace generated by lack of ethical disposability of components at the end of their life has brought pristine environments only in our imagination, with discarded materials even present in the Earth's deepest point, the Mariana Trench. Since the 1950s, only 9% of the used plastic has been adequately recycled. Every year, it is estimated that 4 to 12 million metric tons of plastic waste ends up in oceans. Product creation began with exploiting natural resources to manufacturing to distribution to journeying from use to end of life. A business, unless analyzing their product life cycle, cannot be truly circular model. Life cycle analysis is a prerequisite of circular business modeling. Retaining a circular business model makes sure waste is prevented, managed, and minimized. Selection of raw materials to end life, questioning the recyclability or biodegradability of the product, reducing the chances of landfilling must be prioritized. Some strategies to be utilized can be product design. A good design is a sustainable design with the least negative externalities during the production process. The energy used during the production is also renewable in nature. Take back program, turning old products into raw materials for new products. Through take back programs, companies collect used products from customers and direct them to the manufacturing process. A product design that enables easy separation of product components is imperative for a successful take-back program. For example, origami bottles are designed for easier closed-loop recycling. Proper handling of bioplastics. Bioplastics are basically a mix of plastics with organic material, which help in breaking down. But even if the plastic is 100% compostable, it must be subject to manualized composting in order to better handle bioplastics breaking down into microplastics. Refill systems. Reusing is better than recycling, uses less time, resources, and energy. Packaging is largest end-use market segment, accounting for over 40% of the total plastic usage. Refilling can heavily reduce such end-of-life components deadlock. Waste to raw material. A lot of generally wasted material can be reimagined as raw material. Please note that cycling requires labor. Resource and energy is used in carrying the materials from garbage cans to recycling plants, from trash to dematerialization, with materials inevitably being lost along the way. Remaking a product becomes costly and thus not optimally efficient. It's important to understand that recycling offers the lowest value cycle as compared to reuse and remanufacturing.